People, those are the core of who we are and what our business runs on. 73% of our business is from some type of past client. It's relationships. We just don't want it to be transactional. Add value, add value, add value.
So you like your neighborhood, but your house is too small. One of the things we hear all the time is people get kind of stumped on who is going to be the builder or the contractor. So Josh, in your experience, how does someone navigate through that? What would you say is the best way to do it?
You know, part of it is the neighborhood that you're in. It depends on how big the renovation is going to be. I think it has to do with several options that go into like picking somebody, interviewing two or three builders or contractors, and then looking at quotes. And you know, I think the quotes come back, especially right now in Nashville, they're a little bit all over the place. Mm-hmm. And I think that, you know, it's getting referrals and it's finding out what they've done similar to
that. What about getting it from the architect? Because a lot of people get an architect to draw up the plans.
Yeah, I think you can. I think a lot of people go to the architect first, and I think that a lot of times that's definitely not the first place you should go for the referral or for starting the process. I think that's the wrong place to start.
I think it's a good idea.
I think starting with your agent is probably the very first person. Maybe even starting with your lender is the very first person to talk to, because I think they can give you a lot of insight that other people can't give. An architect doesn't really necessarily care how much you spend on the project.
No. A lot of times they get your pocketbook started. So
yeah,
good advice.
Yeah.